dear students, today we are going to learn virtual functions in C++. First of all, what do you mean by virtual functions? When we perform inheritance, the functions from base class get automatically inherited into the derived class. After deriving that function, there is a conflict between which function needs to be called. That type of performance is known as function overriding, right? So virtual function is the member function of the base class that is being redefined in the derived class, right? And we use a keyword that is virtual. Why we use this? Because we want to perform the dynamic binding and dynamic polymorphism. Polymorphism means many same name functions are performing different tasks at different time. But through operator overloading or function overloading, we are performing it statistically. But when we come with the dynamic functionality, we need virtual functions. When we made the dynamic binding deals with the late binding. We postpone the binding of data or memory at the time of runtime. That provide us the flexibility, as a static binding does not provide any kind of flexibility, but dynamic binding does. So when through virtual function we can achieve that flexibility, and the base class pointer, because without virtual functions, the base class, if we create base class pointer, then the function called will always be from base class, because pointers works from the static binding. Right, once we create pointer and we attach to a class, that is being attached to that class at the compile time, right? So this issue is being resolved with by using a virtual function. The virtual basically the virtual keyword that is preceded in the name of function, the same function which we override in the derived class, tells the compiler that we have to bind that function with the object late when we make a decision at the runtime. Right, at the runtime we make a decision on the basis of the object which call that particular function. So this is known as the late binding or late linkage, which provide a great flexibility, because whichever function we want, either be derived or base class function, whichever function we want to call, we can call that function irrespective of the pointers, irrespective of the object created, right? So this flexibility is performed provided by the virtual functions. There are some basic rules of virtual functions. First of all, the virtual functions, or the function which we are making as virtual, must be a member of some class, right? Without any class, we can't make any function virtual, right? Virtual function can't be static member, because static member can't be redefined or can't be changed or modified, right? They are accessed through object pointers. Okay, so when we create object and a pointer of the base class, they are accessible. Fourth rule is they can't be friend of another class. Virtual function can't be friend of another class. And virtual function, basically the virtual keyword which we are using, we are performing it in function overriding. And function overriding concept comes with the inheritance, right? So when we inherit any class, that class is known as base class, and the class that inherit that class is known as derived class, right? So when the function is defined in the base class, it must be defined even though it is not used. The function which we are making virtual must be defined in the base class, even if it is being used or not, right? This is the rule of virtual function. And the prototype, obviously, if you are performing the function overriding, the prototype of the virtual function of the base class and the derived class must be identical. Otherwise, the compiler gets confused. So which virtual function you are calling from the base class, right? So it must have same name, but different prototype, right? We can't have virtual constructor, but we can have virtual destructor, right? Now we will explore the condition that if we are not using the virtual keyword in our function, then what are the cases happening and why there is a need to use the virtual keyword in our function. See, this is the basic program. There is a class A and a member function or member variable, that is the data member is int x is equals to 5, is it is being initialized with the value of 5, and another we have a member function, that is void display, right? It is displaying the value of x, the simple format of class A. This is class B, that is inheriting class A publicly. Okay, so it has its own data member, that is int y is equals to 10, and it has the same function as A, that is void display. Void display has the same prototype, you can see that we have the same prototype in A and we have the same prototype in B as well, right? So what we are doing here, we are overriding a function that is known as void display. Okay, now from main, what we are doing, attaching the we are creating a base class pointer. After creating that pointer, as we can see that we are creating a base class pointer, so that pointer will get automatically attached to the base class functions and base class data members, right? After attaching creating that pointer, it will get attached to the base class at the time of compile time, so it has a static binding, right? After that, we are creating object on derived class. Now if you want that the pointer point to the object of derived class, then it is not possible, right? So if through this function you can see that there are rigidness in the behavior of the program, that it is not calling any function from derived class, right? It is always calling the function from base class. Okay, so there is as we know that after performing inheritance, the all the functions from the base class is automatically get called in the derived class. But if we want to forcefully call any function from the derived class, if we have a function name conflict or a function overriding feature, then it is creating a problem, because everything is get attached at the compile time, therefore it is unable to fix that problem at runtime. See this, whatever I have said earlier, this slide explains the exactly same, the need for the virtual function is that because which allow the base pointer to access the member of derived class, right? We are accessing the member of derived class, not the base class. Okay, now using the virtual function, what we can do by using the virtual function. Okay, so class A, similarly we have a function. Now the new thing here is we are using a virtual keyword before the void display. You can observe that we are using the virtual keyword in the front of void display only in class A, not in the inherited class B, because as I have told, the rule says that the virtual keyword must be used in the base class, not in the derived class, right? So what we are doing, we are using the function which we are overriding, that is void display, we are using a virtual keyword in front of it. Now after that, what we are doing in main, now we are creating a pointer of base class and object of derived class. Now the answer is derived class is invoked. Earlier the answer was base class was invoked, right? Now the reason behind this is the pointer attachment to that class is being delayed to the compile time, or sorry, to the runtime, or late binding, that is known as dynamic linking, late binding, runtime binding. There are different names, ठीक है. नाउ व्हेन वी कॉल डिस्प्ले दैट पॉइंटर गेट अटैच टू द एड्रेस ऑफ द क्लास और द एड्रेस ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट वी आर पासिंग. सो वी आर द पास वी आर पासिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ बेस क्लास राइट. वी आर पासिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ डिराइव क्लास राइट. वी हैव क्रिएटेड अ ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ डिराइव क्लास बी राइट. सो वी आर पासिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ डिराइव क्लास इन द पॉइंटर ऑफ बेस क्लास. सो इट इज कॉलिंग द डिराइव क्लास फंक्शन नॉट द बेस क्लास फंक्शन. सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट थिंग्स इन द virtual functions. Another term come here was the pure virtual function. As you can see that there is an empty slide of the pure virtual function because it create a thought that what is a pure virtual function. I will tell you definitely. If a class contain a virtual function, all the functions in a class are the if the base class contain a virtual function that is not being defined in the base class, then it become a pure virtual function. Pure virtual function must be defined in derived class irrespective of anything. So pure virtual function must be defined in the derived class, right? And a class that contain pure virtual function become the abstract class. So that's all for the virtual function in C++. I hope you get the concept behind that. Thank you.